Hi guys, welcome to the video, and in this lesson we're going to be looking at carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids are another type of homologous series, and we've seen in our previous video that the word homologous series just means family of compounds with the same functional group. The functional group for a carboxylic acid is the CO. And we can recognize a carboxylic acid also by its name. All carboxylic acids end in this suffix "-oic". For example, we have ethanoic acid. And you can see the "-oic" at the end of the name. Well, there are three carboxylic acids that you guys are expected to be able to draw and recognize in your exam. The first one is methanoic acid. Methanoic acid is one carbon here, and you can see our functional group over there. We have our CO group over here. The second carboxylic acid you guys should be able to recognize is ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid has two carbons in its chain. And you can see again that we have the same functional group, telling us it belongs to the homologous series of carboxylic acids. The formula for methanoic acid is CHCOOH. And again, if you're given the formula, you should be able to recognize that COOH group. For ethanoic acid, the formula would be CH3COOH. And again, we have that COOH group. The third and final carboxylic acid that you guys need to know is called propanoic acid. Propanoic acid has three carbons in its chain. And finally, you can see we have the same functional group for propanoic acid and ethanoic acid and methanoic acid. The formula CH3CH2COOH. And again, you can see we've got our carbon, oxygen, oxygen, hydrogen functional group. Ethanoic acid is the carboxylic acid that's found in vinegar. And we know that vinegar has a very sour taste. But the carboxylic acids can be formed from the oxidation of alcohols. Thank you. Now the oxidation of alcohols occurs because of two things. We can oxidize any of the alcohols that we see in our previous video and turn them into any of these carboxylic acids. In order to do that, we can use acidified potassium dichromate. And we can also use microbes from the air. This is why some people don't put the cork or the lid back on their bottle of wine. The microbes from the air are able to oxidize the alcohol, which is ethanol, into ethanoic acid, which means that the bottle of wine will then have a vinegar taste to it. Now you need to know some of the properties of carboxylic acids. Well, the first property is that they are all soluble or able to dissolve in water. And when these carboxylic acids dissolve in water, they form acidic solutions. And that means that the pH is lower than 7, because that's the pH of an acid. We can also test for carboxylic acids by using calcium carbonate or sodium carbonate. And what will happen is when we add calcium carbonate or sodium carbonate to a carboxylic acid, you'll see a fizzing taking place. That fizzing is due to carbon dioxide gas being released. And we can also use carboxylic acids to produce esters. Esters are produced when we react a carboxylic acid with an alcohol in the presence of a strong acid catalyst. We will look at esters in our next video. Okay guys, thanks for tuning in. Stay in touch for another video.